Hello everybody, welcome back to another Lego City vlog. Jordan here. Today we're going to be working on some details in the city, in which we've been meaning to do for quite some time. We've just been busy with some other projects, such as all the stuff underneath the table, right? That took quite some time. But today we're working up top here, which is quite nice. One thing that the Lego City has been lacking for quite some time is traffic lights. It used to have traffic lights, and then we rebuilt it and forgot to put the traffic lights back in. Well, I don't think we forgot, but we're going to be putting them back in today. Now, recently we ordered some of these decals here from OK Brickworks. And these are actually going to go on our 1x4 green tiles so that we can start to name some of our streets. Also, you can see that our traffic lights have these 2x3 tiles open right here for some advertisements that will be around the Lego City as well. So we're going to be placing all of those. Also, we're going to be working on placing all of our vehicles as well. You will see that there's some vehicles in the city right now, but that's actually not our entire collection of vehicles. We have a whole nother bin somewhere. I'll try and find those and show you. Also, Jose is working on creating some really cool planters. And you can see she's working on her little desk right here. She's got her bin of flowers and leaves, and she's creating some of those awesome Mrs. Bricksie flowers, and we're going to be adding those to our city. Oh, there's the bin of vehicles. That's convenient. So there's the bin of vehicles there in which we need to add, and they're going to go all throughout the city. There's also some other miscellaneous stuff that we're going to be placing in this video as well. Recently, we built a whole bunch of stuff that's just a giant mess on my desk over here, as always. And we're going to be placing this stuff in the Lego City and also in the Lego room. So we got lots going on today. So welcome back to another Lego City vlog. Can't wait to get all these nice details going here. Also, we plan on hopefully telling some stories with the placements of our vehicles. You ready, Jose? Let's get started, because we're going to be bringing this place to the next level. Now, as you saw back there in the Lego City, we've got lots of vehicles to place, but you're probably wondering where all the minifigures are as well. Now, minifigures always come last, but we'll be doing those soon too. But today we're doing vehicles, traffic lights, flowers, some other miscellaneous details. And then after that, we're going to work into the minifigures. And when we do the minifigures, we plan on doing them a lot differently than what we've done in the past. We plan on doing a lot more storytelling and just a lot of different scenes with figures. So it's going to take quite some time, because we probably have, I don't know, a few hundred at least to place in the city. But that's going to be really exciting. But that's not happening today. That will happen in a future update when we bring this city even further than it is now. Well, we've made some tremendous progress here in the Lego City today, and I am so fired up to show you all of the different changes. Starting with all of the traffic lights. It really does add a lot to the Lego City. Each traffic light has the street name on it, also the little sign there. So you can see that one says Toy Open, so it's a toy store in town. And I've made some modifications to the traffic lights themselves. You can see that there's one solid stud there, which is green, meaning that that light there is green. And when we come around to the other side of it, this light over here is also green, and there's a different advertisement. So this is Central Ave, and then you can see that this is Second Street right over here. It's a little bit different. That traffic light there did sort of the 90 degree design, just because I didn't want to overcloud what's going on in front of the town hall. So where the traffic lights are green, the opposite ones are obviously red. And you can see there's different signs on each one. And the cars are passing through the intersection there, and they're stopped right here. Now on Van Brick Ave right over here, we decided to do something a little bit different. We made the traffic light yellow. And this robber here is running from this police officer, and he got in a car crash with a lady right there. You can see there's some debris on the road, and a couple of the pieces are dislodged from the vehicle. And I just love the addition of the street signs. It is awesome. They're sort of all different. And it just adds so much character to the street and to the city. So you can see there's another car turning right here as that light's green. And look, this one's called Sesame Street. And we've got some of the Sesame Street sticker pieces there on the traffic light. And Sesame Street is right there behind the Sanctum Sanctorum. Now you can see there's a lot more vehicles here in the LEGO City. All around. Driving. Repositioned them all and added all those other ones. There's another traffic light area over here. There we go. You've got a garbage truck there. It's a stiff competition because there's another garbage truck company right there. Also, we added a whole bunch more of those flowers and bushes all throughout the city as well. Most of them are actually over here. I just want to show you a few other things in which we did here in the LEGO City, like in the downtown core, and also discuss some of the plans in which we plan on doing soon. So right here, we've got the pizza truck and also the ice cream truck. Eventually, we're going to build the inverted corner, which is the assembly square inverted corner. Oh, looks like I got to realign my police station there. Must have bumped into it when I was doing some installation of lights. Right here, we've got a yield sign. As not every single intersection needs to be controlled by traffic lights, I don't think. And then we've got the railway crossing right here. Now, I want to showcase a few of these signs. They were sent to me by Abe. Check it out. They're like military propaganda ones there on 2nd Street. And you will notice that some of the green signs are open for the taking. I just have to order more stickers because the sticker pack from OK Brickworks only came with two of each. So we need to get some more because sometimes there's more than two streetlights on each street. Right here, we have another propaganda print piece. And then here in Pop Culture Street, we've got the other railroad crossing. I've still got to fix all of my train track. As you can see, I've got to ballast some curves there. That's the only curve that's not ballast. I've got to get on that. And then right here on Washing Brick Avenue, we have some of those propaganda signs on all three of these as well. So you can see this is 1st Street and Washing Brick Ave. So adding traffic lights definitely adds a lot. Now, I am planning on, or Jose and I are planning on doing some other changes here to the LEGO City downtown core as well. And that involves moving these mini modulars. Haunted House in the Graveyard might make their way underneath to the scenes. And right here we have our mini modulars, which take up two base plates and then there's an open base plate there in the corner. So we're building an arcade mock. So what we want to do is build a custom corner, then the arcade mock will go there, and then build a custom inverted corner there. And then we have some other base plates that will be open when we move the graveyard and the haunted house. So we want to make that a custom sort of corner there that sort of seamlessly flows into the custom skyscrapers. So that's sort of all custom back there. I think that'd be pretty neat if we were able to do that. Because then starting with the Avengers Tower and working our way all the way around here would all be custom buildings, which would be really fun. But where would we move the mini modulars? Well, we'd actually bring them over here, in which we have some more traffic lights. This is Illegal Way, and I believe it's Yellow Brick Road. Yeah, Yellow Brick Road. A couple more propaganda posters there. We figured Illegal Way makes sense because it's right outside of this custom police station. But we would bring the mini modulars right over here, because they take up two base plates, so we'll be able to fit them here. Maybe build another section of mini modulars. And those are like nice little shops and whatnot. So they look really good by the beach. And then that'll open up that space over there so that we can build some more custom stuff. We've got our zoo area here. You can see Jose put some of those planters there for now, just to fill in the spot there. And she's also built this new sign for the aquarium as well, which will replace my squigglies. And we're gonna be working on the zoo relatively quick here. I've decided just to throw up a very quick wall. And then we've added some very rough draft fencing here and stood up some minifigures where the farm will be going as well. It's good to clean things up though. We took a long time, or it took a long time to do what we did today. Those traffic lights actually require quite a bit of patience. And you'll see some other markers on street lamps. Now, something else that I want to do is actually order a whole bunch, and I mean thousands, of 2x2 gray tiles, as I would like to tile this entire area here all the way down to the beach. So starting here in the residential area and working our way all the way down to the beach. I'd like to get that all tiled and looking beautiful, just like it does here in the downtown core. Also, I need to do some more tile work, but I'm out of tiles along here, all along here, and all the way back there by the skyscrapers. I'm out of tiles, so I've probably got to order, I don't know, 2,000 or 3,000 more to get that done, probably more than that actually. And then once we get that done, it'll look pretty good. Next up, we're gonna be doing minifigures. And when we add minifigures, our whole goal is going to be storytelling. Let us know what you think of all the changes here in the Lego room that we made during this Lego room vlog. Remember to like, subscribe, and stay tuned. Thanks for popping by and have a great one.